Howdy, YouTube family. It's Bold CRNA coming to you again with another day's topic. So today we're going to be talking about the juicy, controversial topic of, is the doctorate better than the master's degree in anesthesia? So let's get into it. So first, I'm going to talk to you a little bit about the regulations that the doctorate is going to be required. The Council on Accreditations, which is the organization that decides which places are allowed to be CRNA programs or not, decided years ago that as of January 1st, 2025, all graduating students from CRNA programs must have a doctorate when they're graduating in order to take boards and to become a CRNA. The minimum length of a doctorate degree has to be 36 months, which is 3 years. The previous minimum length of the master's degree was 24 months. So to break down that new regulation for you, let me explain. This doesn't mean that up to the year of 2025, you can start a master's degree program and you're fine. This means that by the time you finish the program, in 2025, January 1st, you had to have already graduated and taken boards at that point, which means back yourself up 2 to 3 years before that was when you would have to have started your program and started your education to have finished in time to have taken boards and be done with them before January 1st, 2025. So that pretty much means you got about a year maybe left from the time that I'm shooting this video to get into a master's program. After that, this whole question is gonna go away, whether a master's is better than a doctorate or blah, blah, blah. It won't matter because all of you will have to have one in order to be graduating and practicing. As of right now on this day, I think it's June 16th, 2020, there is 44 programs listed on the Council on Accreditation's website as a master's. There are 100 doctoral programs listed on their website. Now, I believe there's some crossover there because some of these programs that are considered masters, the 44 that are considered masters, quite a few of those I know are already accepting doctoral students, but they still have a couple master's students who haven't quite graduated yet. So they're still included in this list, but essentially they've already transferred over. Like, new incoming students are already coming in as doctoral, but some of their other upperclassmen who are preparing to graduate are gonna graduate with a master's degree. So logistically, for your purposes of applying to schools, there are probably less than 44 master's programs, even in America, right? So let's talk a little bit about why you should just do a doctorate instead of a master's and if that's necessary. So like we said, this is gonna be the new standard of practice. Everyone's gonna be having this. All future graduates will have this. Do you really wanna be in practice with experience and be a good provider and have people coming in behind you with less experience and new graduates who have a higher degree than you, who may get management positions over you that you really should deserve, that you are capable of doing, but they may get that role because of a degree they have. I have some friends who were in master's programs when I was in my doctorate program, and they said, oh, you know, I plan to get my doctorate too, it's no big deal, I just don't want to get it right now. I'm gonna go back later and get it. Why wait when you're already in school now, you're going through all the hell that you're going through in CRNA school? Do you really want to graduate and then sign yourself up voluntarily to go back to school later? Maybe once you've got more kids, or you've got a mortgage now, or your job commitment is, you know, really tied you down. You really wanna go back, and you're gonna have to fork out money out of your personal funds to pay for this again. So maybe you finally get your student loans paid off from your master's, and now you're gonna go back in debt again to pay for your doctorate. Like, how likely do you think you're really gonna do that? And if you do that, how miserable are you gonna be when you do that? I can't imagine, and I knew I would be. So that's why I never even thought about the idea of doing a master's, because I knew I wanna go to school one time, I wanna be finished when I finish, I wanna have a terminal degree when I get done, and I wanna know I am forever done, and I never have to go back to school, and I pay off these student loans this one time, and I never will have student loans again. The other aspect is most master's programs are not 24 months. Most master's programs, at least in the past, is the ones who haven't shut down already, they were like 28 months, 29 months. That's over 2 years, which means if you just bumped yourself up to a doctorate for 36 months, that's about 9 months, maybe 8 or 9 months more. That's not even a full year of time that you're dedicating more to go from your master's to your doctorate. And now, if you choose to go back later in the future, it may be a year or more of your time that you're taking to get that doctorate. Another aspect is once you graduate with your doctorate, you're prepared and ready to become a professor. You may, of course, not want to be a professor right away, just like I don't want to be a professor this year right now, but it is nice to know that I can go work in an academic environment and still make a good income and impact the future generations and have a career that I enjoy. And my final point on this is having a terminal degree is very satisfying, and I think it's a career goal a lot of people have, an educational goal a lot of people have, is to be at their top level of education in their field. It's the standard of expectation for pretty much all healthcare degrees in this professional arena that we practice in now, is that you're going to have a doctorate. You know, pharmacists have them, chiropractors have them, physical therapists have them, psychologists have them, dentists have them. Everyone else has already transitioned and been there. Optometrists have them. CRNAs were one of the last lingering people behind who do a pretty advanced job and have a lot of responsibility on our plate and actually get paid very well, but we were still lingering behind on the education of having a master's. So now that they've transitioned to doctorate, you should embrace that as well. I know a lot of you guys are concerned about your doctoral project or your thesis or whatever. Just remember, this is not that bad. It is time consuming. I will say I spent about a year and a half on it. It's a lot of writing, submitting it to the review board, having them go through it and mark it up with red pen and tell you this is moved, you know, this APA format's not right and this needs to be cited a different way and you need 15 more, you know, works cited and you need to do all these different changes and stuff. It's very time consuming, takes a lot of effort. It's not easy, but I will say it's not a thesis. You're not gonna spend 6 years like on a PhD trying to formulate this. You shouldn't have to create the research from scratch. Mostly what a DNP project is about is you assimilating data and information out there into changing the practice of a current place. So it may be that you encourage people to use Esmolol more during induction for these purposes, and you go through and do research, and you might do a little bit of trials of like you used Esmolol on these 20 cases and not on these 20, whatever, come up with some research or some evidence from that. But they are something that teaches you how to take data, assimilate that data, improve practices. That is essentially what you are as a DNP nurse. Your degree is a practice doctorate. You're not designed to be a PhD who comes up with their own raw from scratch research and formulates something new. You're there to assimilate data and research that's already been done, which stuff is good research and which is not, and figure out biases in research and what things that you should look for, and then take that to change the practice clinically of where you're going to be working or where other people may be working. And they do break it down in steps for you over time, so it's not something that just hits you all at once. So I hope that gave you a little bit of some perspective on why doctorate versus master's. I'm still interested in whether some of you guys heard all of this and said, you know what, I want, if they still offered the master's, I would totally do the master's instead, and I would just do that and be done with it, and I don't care about ever having a doctorate or any of the rest of the stuff that I talked about. If you don't want that, let me know in the comments below. You know, I'd love to hear from you guys about it. And make sure and go follow me over on Instagram. It's BoltCRNA over there. And otherwise, that's Bolt out.